The Farewell Hajj. After Mecca had been conquered, Prophet Muhammad and many of his companions returned to Medina. It was the 9th year of the Hijra, known as Year of the Delegations, since each tribe from all over the Arabian Peninsula sent a group of representatives to greet Prophet Muhammad, to declare their allegiance and pledge their commitment to him. Prophet Muhammad and his companions, peace be upon them, hosted the group of representatives in the Prophet's mosque in Medina. The representatives of each tribe heard the Holy Quran being recited, watched his companions pray, and learned about Islam from Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Many of the representatives believed in the message immediately and were satisfied, and some did not accept as smoothly as the others. The representatives of the tribes returned to their people, calling them to accept Islam, teaching them what they'd learned, and telling them they need to get rid of all their idols. Eventually, the whole Arabian Peninsula had accepted Islam. On the 10th year of the Hijra, Allah, the Glorious, revealed a command to perform Hajj for those capable of doing so. Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, announced that he was going to perform Hajj pilgrimage to Mecca. Flocks of people, tens of thousands of people, from all over joined him. It was the largest gathering in the Arabian Peninsula at the time. Throughout the Hajj pilgrimage, Prophet Muhammad gave several sermons, including the famous primary sermon, on the Day of Arafat, from the Plain of Arafat, Mount of Mercy. There, he declared equality and solidarity between all Muslims and reminded them of all the duties Islam had enjoined upon them. He forbade stealing, killing people, involvement in interest, and more. He commanded everyone to be good and just to their wives and women. He relayed the famous words to them of, "There is no superiority of an Arab over a non-Arab, nor of a non-Arab over an Arab, nor a white over a black, nor a black over a white, except by taqwa, piety, fear of God, and God consciousness." He told them there are two things if they hold on to, they will not go astray. And that is the Book of Allah, the Holy Quran, and the Sunnah, the teachings of the last and final prophet, Muhammad, peace be upon him. He reminded them that they would return to their Lord one day, who will judge them based on their deeds. In the end, he asked them, "Have I not conveyed the message?" The companions replied, "Yes." Then Prophet Muhammad raised his hands in the air and looked up into the sky and said three times, "O Allah, you bear witness."